Hey YouTubers, Hankster here, and welcome to another Star Wars movie review. And this review, of course, is focusing on the final installment of the original Star Wars trilogy, Star Wars Episode 6, The Return of the Jedi. Now, of course, this movie, of course, was a big focus back in 1983, with production going on with it. Of course, back then they didn't have anything like the internet or anything. The closest that people got to any information about Star Wars was through this magazine at the time. And also at the time, they were, of course, working with a lot of different titles for the movie. To keep people from thinking they were filming another Star Wars movie, they disguised it as Blue Harvest. But of course, when the actual Star Wars cast members start showing up on set, and of course that blew everything. And of course, the production people kind of were in disagreement with George Lucas with the working title of the name. They kind of wanted to work with the title "The Revenge of the Jedi," but George Lucas wanted to go with "Return of the Jedi," being that obviously Jedi did not take revenge. And of course, obviously, the revenge part of the title would be saved up for Episode 3, which of course would be The Revenge of the Sith. In the last moment, George Lucas finally got his way, and of course it was Return of the Jedi became the official title for Episode 6. And of course, at the time, it was still, of course, considered the third Star Wars movie, even though it was also considered Episode 6. And, of course, it was, of course, the final confrontation between Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader. And, we, of course, also finally physically meet the Emperor, as he, of course, would be portrayed as with Ian McKellen, who, of course, would later, of course, play Palpatine in the prequel movies. If you got to know anything, the Emperor wasn't even mentioned in Episode 4, even though it was called the Empire. We didn't know there was an Emperor. We thought that maybe Darth Vader was in charge of everything, being he was considered the main villain of the whole production. And, they did mention the Emperor briefly in a few things, but it wasn't like we actually saw the Emperor or knowing his presence until, like, at least Episode 5, but then, that wasn't even Ian McKellen, that was another actor playing the Emperor in the original production of Empire Strikes Back. Of course, when they redid everything, they, of course, put Ian playing the Emperor. Of course, that was, like, kind of during when they were doing Episode 3, and they were redoing it for another, DVD release and all. Now, of course, there wasn't a total lot of character introductions, except, of course, for Jabba the Hutt. We forgot to finally see what Jabba the Hutt was going to look like. Now, of course, as I said in the Episode 4 review, he was originally going to be introduced as an actual character, but because of production problems, mostly because of financing, they weren't able to do it. And that was actual footage. If you of course see the redone start version of that scene with Harrison Ford playing Han Solo with the Jabba the Hutt and all, that actually was an actual scene filmed. It was actually a human character playing Jabba, and of course they were going to do what they actually did, but you try to use a puppet or some sort of animation or something like that. So, and of course, they wound up using CGI when they redid it. And of course, they had to redo it again to make Jabba look better than he did in the original redo. But of course, as I said, we met up with Jabba the Hutt, and Silas said, of course, that was his end. We also thought we saw the end of Boba Fett, but of course, and a lot of expanded universe productions, mostly books and stuff. Apparently, Boba Fett survived, and I guess in the new, redone expanded universe, he survives still. We'll have to see. Like I said, they're going to do a Boba Fett movie in the future, I think. Obviously, this of course is the movie that of course ends the Anakin Skywalker story arc. which was going, of course, obviously start with episode one. As you know, now with episode seven, it's kind of got a new arc going, being that Anakin is now dead and all, even though we do are still going to hear his name and Darth Vader's name going to be mentioned through most of the productions, he's not going to be an actual presence anymore, unless, of course, they decide to make have Hayden Christensen return as the Force spirit of Anakin. We'll let's see about that. Now, of course, another interesting introduction was a new race of warriors known as the Ewoks, which, of course, cute little Taybear-looking things that, of course, that helped turn the balance of the Battle of Endor to the favor of the Rebellion. And, of course, help end the second Death Star, which, of course, was being built in orbit around Endor and all. And, obviously, of course, the Ewoks were so much loved by kids, they, of course, got their own animated series for a couple seasons, ironically, off on ABC. And you think about it, both the Ewoks animated series and Droids, both Star Wars-inspired animated series would wind up on ABC, and of course, back then, ABC was not owned by Disney or anything, and neither was Star Wars, ironically enough. If they did it today, if ABC still had Saturday morning programming, that would be the most appropriate place now, because, you know, that would be, but of course now with Disney owning its own cable networks and everything, they pretty much can air these series themselves. Of course, with such series as Clone Wars and Rebels and everything. But yeah, there was shortly after the release of episode 6, there was two television series based on Star Wars, which was not really connected to the actual Star Wars story, even though Droids featured R2-D2 and C-3PO, they weren't interacting with other major Star Wars characters. They were kind of like their own separate adventures with new characters to interact with and everything, which really, you don't know if that was supposed to be like post episode 6 or whatever. Obviously, you know, you're probably not going to see, obviously, not with episode 7, they probably didn't have those adventures. We don't know. And of course, Ewoks was sort of a sort of like Muppet Babies. Is it Star Wars for answers to Muppet Babies, or all these little adventures of cute animals having adventures and stuff that a lot of Saturday morning programming was geared to at the time, along with superhero shows. But that was, of course, another result of Return of the Jedi. Of course, we did see the final, you know, even though it was kind of, we didn't know at the time, we didn't know about it until episode one also, was, of course, the fact that this was the finalization of the prophecy that Anakin was, of course, the chosen one, and he would bring balance to the Force, and by destroying the Emperor, and, of course, Darth Vader, which, of course, wind up being himself, in the process, and of course, I guess that really didn't make much difference by episode 7, because there's, you know, the bad guys are back, even though it's not really the Sith, as we know of right now. All in all, it was pretty good space battles, of course, obviously, with Lando leading the way with piloting a Millennium Falcon. You gotta remember, he once owned the Millennium Falcon, but lost it in a gambling bet with Han. So he knows what he was doing. He was piloting the ship. It wasn't the first time he ever piloted it, even though he did lose the radar dish. And you notice they did fix the situation in Episode 7. There's a new radar dish on the Millennium Falcon, if you pay attention on there. So they did remember to put in a new radar dish after Lando knocked it off during the Death Star battle. We get to see more of the Rebellion ships this time around. We got, and of course, we also got introduced to such characters as Admiral Ackbar. It's a trap. But all in all, this was, of course, the pretty much a good ending to the original Star Wars trilogy, and of course, the, as I said, the, I like to call the Anakin Skywalker arc of the Star Wars saga. Now we're going into some more of the kind of, we're still going into Skywalker storyline with Luke still being around, and Leia, and of course now with, you know, everybody knows what happened to Han Solo. you know, if you haven't seen the movie, it's been over a month. I don't know why you have it waiting this long. It's not really considered spoilers if it's been over a month at all. Here it is, and then end of January, for crying out loud. But all in all, and of course, I even like the redone, and you know, the ending of the movie when they redid everything and they had all the different places that we saw in the storyline celebrating the fall of the Empire and everything. Was a good twist as opposed to just having Ewoks dancing and singing, doing num num. Or they could have mixed it all together. It would have been nice. But, all in all, it was a, you know, good ending point for that part of the storyline. Now, of course, we're going on with not just the original trilogy characters, but also with new characters with the new trilogy that's started last year. And all, of course, our next review will be going into Episode 7, The Force Awakens, my heavily anticipated review, of course, that movie. I have seen it, and I will be doing a review shortly, so don't worry about that. And hope you enjoyed my little review of The Return of the Jedi, and stay tuned here for more reviews and whatnot here on the Multiverse, and may the Force be with you.